mentioned that it was 23 years is what they had mentioned. It took that long. Could have been done in within one period of 5 years. The difficulty for them was there was a huge blunder. The blunder committed took 15 years now to undo,
Madam,
reboot.
One minute. Blunder committed 15 years. Where were they in the picture in 15 years? Everything has happened on its own.
No,
They
no, no.
come into. You mean to say
They
that
don't.
you, are you saying that the chief minister was of the idea or family of the chief minister or idea of buying this land in
No,
1997?
no, not at all.
No.
A4.
2004, the story commences from
It
this
doesn't
family.
commence from the date that the brother-in-law buys it.
Yes.
It commences from the date A4 applies, asking for denotification.
That
This
is
is,
Devraj.
yes, Devraj,
Devraj is an accused.
he's an accused. Now, what he does is, he works in the education department. He suppresses it. The whole scheme of all of this starts with a misrepresentation. He states, this is my only source of income. This is my agricultural income. And therefore, please denotify. Whereas he works here in the education department. It starts with that. And as I've taken your lordship through the periods when this was involved, it started from there. So from the period when Devraj had applied, it started. So what I'm trying to say is that 23 years is a fault of theirs, not ours, that they made a big blunder in the way they went about it. After finishing with denotification and then conversion, and then, oops, we've gone the wrong way. Maybe we need to take another route. And then applications start for compensatory sites. Now, the other issue that they seem to mention is that 50-50. It is not 50-50, reason being, in the Muda sale deeds to the wife of the petitioner, it states clearly that it's under the 1991 scheme. Now, the reason this is extremely important, your lordship, is that 60-40 allotment, if it is 60-40, say about in an acre, development 45% goes, 55% is only left in 45 allotment, the parks, the roads, the amenities, all of that. 55% is left. In 55%, 40% of that is what a landowner is entitled to, which is be about 22%, which is about 9,500 square feet in 1 acre. 3 acres, let's assume for a minute that they have a flow of title, which they don't. 3 acres, they would have to get at best 28,000 square feet. What is given is on the 50-50 scheme,
Correct.
38,000 square feet. Now,
Government had changed the scheme by then, 50-50 had come in
the
2015.
sale deed itself talks of what scheme would be applicable to them. So the question of changing that would not arise. Your lordship, as he had mentioned, I have to just make it very clear where Devanuru comes. That is this village that they're talking about. It's precisely 2 hours from Mysore, if we do it on the map. Now, if I have to draw a parallel, if a layout is being made,
Is it
that
not?
is exactly the reason why I'm trying to state is that we need to say where Devanuru is. Devanuru is 2 hours distance from Mysore, if we take, say, Palace as the center point. If your lordship, there is a layout being developed, say, beyond Jigni, am I entitled to compensatory sites in Indiranagar and choicest of ones and a sprinkling of all of them and 14 of them in Indiranagar, I would not be entitled to. One of the defense taken earlier was that these are not incentive sites which have to be given in the very layout. They can be given anywhere. Your lordship, because they're not incentive, they're compensatory. Compensation sites are always site for site. For example, if there's a flyover being made
That's
in
right.
the heart of town and they take my site, then they have to give it to me in the urban area and they can't compensate me with that. So if my area is being taken in Jayanagar, I can be given in Baswangudi or BTM equivalent value. I cannot be given something where I have own in Jigni and then I get in Indiranagar. That is not possible. Your lordship, next. The allegation is that, lordship, that there are a lot of sanctions that are languishing, not met the light of the day, and this has been done in a tearing hurry. Lordship, all our brothers and sisters in the bar keep cursing us that we've taken up so much of your lordship's time over here for this matter. They can all say, where is the tearing hurry in this matter? This matter is not of any great importance. This matter could have waited. But your lordship, the point is ultimately...
I have granted an interim order. So that is the reason.
I'm just trying to say...
Are you saying I should not take this?
No. Hmm? The contrary. I'm trying to state that they cannot say governor took this matter up while others are languishing.
Drawing
a parallel with what all my brothers and sisters have been cursing us with. But that cannot be done.
Are they still doing?
I'm sure they are. Your lordship. So ultimately, it's the discretion of the governor. There could be other reasons for other matters, but that cannot be taken up now, right now, to say that there are malafides in this and therefore it was taken up earlier. Your lordship, the rights of Dev.
Their illustration quoted.
The pressure is on by all of the others, your lordship. The CN's wife, they're stating that others were also allotted. Your lordship, there is not one other case where allotment took place
in Vijayanagar.
In Vijayanagar area or any other well-developed area which is not in the heart of Mysore as opposed to being 2 hours away. Now, your lordship, even let's assume they're saying, okay, give us back our lands. 3 acres of lands worth 4 lakhs when it was sold. At best, it becomes 40 lakhs. Worst case, best case scenario, 3 crores. It does not go to up to 60 crores. That doesn't even happen in prime Bangalore area. And that could be the root of the ultimate problem. Your lordship, then also going into the aspect of many others, denotification. Your lordship, denotification can happen. There's land mafia everywhere. All of that denotification happens with whatever reasons. Can that be a reason that this... In terms of parity with other frauds, this cannot be excluded. It's ultimately a public servant. Your lordship, also with respect to the 262 and 264, your lordship, stating that 262, both in fact were owned by Ninga only. What happened was... 462 and 464.
Yeah, survey number one. Yes.
462 was also owned by the very same person, but he sold it to someone else. And this was what remaining for the three brothers ultimately. And flow of title doesn't happen. That's all.
Done?
Done, your lordship.
Yes.